think about the pace of life and how busy we are in our lives? You know, I was thinking about my own life, and I was thinking about Vacation Bible School 2 years ago. See, I'm a children's pastor, and so I helped to lead that. And when I was thinking about a couple years ago, I looked at my schedule, about how many days I worked, about how many hours I worked each day, and I figure I worked at least 84 hours that week. Getting up in the morning, going all day long, coming home and just going to bed, hardly had any conversation with my children or my wife. It was as if the day just passed by. Don't we do that too? I mean, don't we have those same crazy schedules? Let me just give you an example that might relate to your family. You get up in the morning, early in the morning, it's time to get the kids dressed, help them have breakfast, get their lunches packed, get them off to the school bus or drive them to school. Then it's time for you to rush to get to the office, work hard all day long. Then you come home, there's no time to eat dinner at home. We just gotta grab a bite from whatever fast food restaurant we come by so that we can get to practice or get to the game. And then after the game is over, then we come home and it's time for homework. So you spend your time helping your kids do their homework, and then finally they go to bed, and now it's time for you to do whatever chores or whatever responsibilities you have around the house. And then you collapse, fall into bed. 24 hours has passed. And then pretty soon, 24 hours has passed, a whole week has passed, a whole month has passed, and you don't even know where the time has gone. But what if we could live life differently? You know, does it have to be that way, that days just pass by? You know, Jesus actually talks about this in the New Testament. He talks about two different kinds of time. One of those times is called chronos time. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's the time that passes from the moment that you're born until the day that you die. But then there's a different time. There's a different time that's called kairos time. And this is time that is filled with Jesus or pregnant with Jesus. What if we could live our moments in kairos time, where Jesus guides us in what we're doing, where Jesus is leading us, where Jesus is shaping us into who we were meant to be? You have to be intentional to have kairos time. But kairos time can change our lives, can help form us into the people that Jesus Christ created us to be. So what can we do about that? What can you do about that? What if you sat down, took your calendar for a whole week, wrote everything out that you're doing, and looked and seriously asked yourself the question, is there time for Jesus in that schedule? You know, are there things that really do need to be cut out of that schedule so that Jesus could be filling your time, kairos time? Or are there moments when you can take and consciously put Jesus into that moment, allow Him to be into that moment with you? Can you imagine what it would be like if Jesus filled our moments as a family, Jesus filled our moments with our children? If we could look back on the 18 years that we have with our children, we could look back and we could say, Jesus was a part of that, and Jesus was shaping me, and Jesus was shaping my children to become all that He created our family, each of us, to be. What an incredible vision that would be. I want to invite you on that journey too, and I thank you very much.